Jim Zellmer. My name is Reverend Charles Uhlik. I'm the rector and pastor here at Grace Episcopal Church. Let us, with our masks, singing, rise up, you saints of God, in the insert that was handed to you as you came into church.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. The word of the Lord. The psalm appointed for this day is 121st psalm. We will read responsively by half verse. I lift up my eyes to the hills.
From where my help is to come.
My help comes from the Lord.
Maker of heaven and earth.
He will not let your foot be moved.
And he watches over you with all his sleep.
Behold, he who keeps watch over Israel. The Lord himself watches over you, so that the sun shall not strike you by day. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. The Lord shall watch over your going out and your coming in. A reading from the letter to the Romans. All who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God, for you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, It is that very Spirit bearing witness within our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. In fact, we suffer with him so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
Also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
This is from John chapter 14, verses 1 through 6. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God and believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I have to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may also be. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him,
Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
May what I am about to say be in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. To boldly go where no one has gone before. I think of Jim in this respect, and as I remember him, as he was a man who loved Star Trek, but more importantly, as we listen to our scriptures today, we sometimes can think of death as being an uneasy, unwelcoming thing. But Jim faced death quite openly. He faced it with courage, strength, an endearing love for his family. As we gather ourselves today, the passages of John's Gospel reminds us of that we sometimes can be on uneasy ground that is sometimes unshakable, when we sometimes with death, we don't know next what to do. But we do know what to do, because Jesus gave us the way, the truth, and the life. He helps us understand that with faith, that all things are possible, and that we can feel, even though that death comes upon us, is not the end. It is sometimes in these crazy days that we have been facing that we sometimes know that life is not always so simple. We sometimes can know that our families, as we grow up and live in families, sometimes aren't always as perfect as mother knows best or father's knows best. Some of these old shows remind us and sometimes can put things up on a pillar where they're not always as perfect as they seem. Jesus knows this, and our scriptures from Romans and Isaiah to remind us as well. Then in our suffering, we can find strength. that we need to keep going with our lives even when things aren't always perfect. Jim was a beautiful golfer. Well, if you golfed with him, you probably know that there were probably some things that he said that probably weren't always that great. But that's all golfing. Frustration, it's like life. Seeking that perfect game isn't always perfect. We are all frail and in our human suffering, and in our own suffering, we can find strength in that. It is that abundant life that Jesus Christ gives to us in our suffering that we can know that life is not always going to be the straight path. Sometimes it's kind of crazy. Even as we look to the stars, like Jim loved to do with astronomy, and knowing to look and to see how the beautiful space were always there for us. God's grace is always being poured out upon us, even in us, that we still have to live in sometimes unsettling times. But we boldly go to continue to move out to the next realm, where God, who is our higher power, for some who have found not strength in their faith and has been on rocky, certainly during these uncertain times. But for Elaine and Mary Catherine and the boys and all the family today, and all of you, and especially Jim's dad, we know that life is there with us as we hold each other's hands. We give each other hugs, even when it's not necessarily socially distancing, but that's okay. We need to comfort each other, even sometimes when it's even difficult. We sometimes can find ourselves from generation to generation thinking we all have the answers. Jim certainly knew that. He didn't have all the answers. And his practice as a physician, he knew what he was trying to do was doing his best. And when he wanted to work with veterans, and he found comfort in doing that, there was peace, I think, Jim had. He liked being with those men and women who served their country with strength and courage. I think in some ways the same way Jim tried to live his life. Not always perfect, but with strength and courage. To boldly go where no one else may never come. We sing Alleluia in the season of Easter. Wherever you come from, whatever faith community you belong to, find strength and comfort wherever you go. And if you don't have a faith community, I invite you to please seek one out. To find that God is not, by our God standards, all out there. God is here with us today. He's sitting next to you. He's sitting with the people that love you. And even in these times when we find ourselves in social isolation, we can find each other on social media with words of encouragement. Tenacity is what Jesus is trying to remind us, and to have that faith in the resurrection. He's trying to tell his disciples, us, that we will have a new beginning. And for this family, who I love very much, and for a man who loved his family very, very much, he took great care to make sure he tried to do what he could to be with us in these last days. I am the way, the truth, and the life, Jesus tells us. Let us also remind ourselves that in our legacy of, like Jim, we continue to pass on the strength of love to each other, strength of hope that will never be unbending because it is based in Jesus Christ. God who loves, who forgives, and gives us hope. to once again to boldly go with a loving hand. As a husband, as a father, and as a friend. My friends in Christ, let us now stand, and turning to page 3 in your worship aid, in the assurance of eternal life given at baptism, let us proclaim our faith and say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. Third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven. He sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Almighty God, who has knit together thine elect in our communion and fellowship in the mystical body of thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, grant, we beseech thee, to thy whole church in paradise and on earth, thy light and thy peace.
Amen.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and that through the grave and the gate of death, we may pass with him to our joyful resurrection.
Amen.
Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that the Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days.
Amen.
Grant to thy faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve thee with a quiet mind.
Amen.
Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in thy fatherly care, that casting all their grief on thee, they may know the consolation of thy love.
Amen.
Grant us, with all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, to have our consummation and bliss in thy eternal and everlasting glory, and with blessed Jim and with all thy saints to receive the crown of life, which thou hast promised to all who share in the victory of thy Son, Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, if you please join me in singing A Mighty Fortress Is Our God, in your insert.
Thank you.
together, let us also now pray the prayer Jesus gives us and strengthens us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Give rest, O Christ, to thy servant with thy saints.
Where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing but life everlasting.
Thou art immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and unto the earth shall we return. For thou didst ordain when thou createst me, saying, dust thou art, and unto the dust thou shalt return. All we go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Give to the servant with the saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing but life everlasting.
Into thy hands, O merciful Savior, we commend thy servant Jim. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech thee, a sheep of thy own fold, a lamb of thy own flock, a sinner of thy own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of thy mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light.
Amen.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us as we sing our recessional hymn, God, our Helper in Ages Past.